Hello, everybody. It's Shizato, and you know me. Coming at you with episode 16. Yes, for 16 episodes. That's 4 squared. That is 2 to the 4th power. Anyways, we're doing the International B Tour of Europe, a race event for European cars that takes place on a series of European courses. Climb aboard your favorite Euro racer, and go for gold. So we're doing France Hatch Grand Prix, which I hate, Circuit de Spa-Francorchamps, which I really like, and then the Ascari track, which is in Spain. So Belgium, Spain, and Britain. Okay. The vehicle we are let's do this real quick. Apparently it's to 540 performance points or less, so we're gonna max 540. So we're gonna run a BMW M4 coupe, 464 horsepower, 1300 kilos, on sport sauce, and oh, that's right, I'm on racing tires, so it's going to set me back to sport hard. So I'm going to put install sport sauce real quick. Take a drink of my lovely monster. So let's take care of this really quick. Sport sauce. 10 grand, worth it. There we go. So we got a selection of vehicles from Mercedes, Volkswagen. Wait, these are mostly German, what the hell? So, as usual, as per se, I've tested this car before, so it doesn't need to have the traction control turned off. And hey, phone, you're drunk again. No, you're not. So, there's my... oh, there it is, going being drunk. This is, like, essentially the ultimate... the ultimate M4. Despite the fact that all you can hear is the transmission. Hey, look at that. That's beauty right there. Past the S3 into 6th gear, heading at 145-ish. Yeah, so I bought this after I saw someone else have this car. And so it works. And it's number 72, kind of like how one of the BMW M3 GTs are. Give a tiniest of taps to the Esprit. This isn't sentient, as it doesn't have a mind of its own. So not all Germans are sentient. And it beats itself, pretty much. And there's the Esprit that was in the lead. So yeah, this is... hopefully gonna be quick since it's only 1:36 a lap. Oop. Kinda broken the slide there. So yeah, this has a really high rev range compared to what it was stock. Because I think stock it had topped out about 7,200 RPM, now goes to over 8,000. Crush Scouter, because if you didn't know, the over 9,000 joke is actually over 8,000. It's been proved by many sources. So, yeah. Unintended joke is intended. I say this is actually really nice to drive with at 540. No, 540. 440. That's how much performance points that Lotus Elise I bought. Which I actually might end up using. Nah, I think the sand is a little bit better. It's more predictable. I did not mean to blare the horn. Trying to get this race done and over with as quickly as possible because I don't like this track. Even though I actually seem to be doing really well on it. Switch back to this cam. I don't know. Like, this is kind of tied with the Streets of Willow circuit. I don't really like Streets of Willow. At all. Hey, phone, you're drunk. Stop being drunk. Looks like camera can't handle speed. My need for speed. Okay, I really need to stop making trying to crack a joke. Like, because I'm not laughing. If I'm not laughing, then probably none of you guys are laughing. It's actually more entertaining when I use the Arnold voice. Damn. That was the last thing I was thinking about with this car. Spinning it out. That's what happens when you catch a tire on the grass. So yeah. There. And we are clicking at breakneck speeds. And we're understeering. It would actually be really fun to drive this around the Nürburgring. Since it's obedient compared to the rest of the Germans. Except for that Audi R18 that was in the, whatchamacallit, the Goodwood Festival of Speed thing. So yeah, we finished that in under 10 minutes. And, okay, so there's that. 64,000 credits. So we're going to hit our 600k at the end of this, and I don't know. I said I was going to buy the Spirit, wasn't it? Didn't I? So I might end up buying that at the end. Because I hear that's actually really good. Not really. Ooh. Look at three laps, yay. And we're just going to go right on ahead. And test our straight line performance with less power. Well, because before this had like 590 horsepower. I assumed this was going to be like 600, like the Japan thing. So I don't know why I clicked on this as 464 horsepower. So it's about 470 horsepower. Yay! So I'm expecting in a little bit some Taco Bell, because Taco Bell is amazing. Not really, but Doritos Locos Tacos, though. Doritos Locos Tacos, though. Nacho cheese. It's nacho cheese. Whoa. That started, like, immediately. The inside of the Brera. Past the Megane, because this thing has double the horsepower. Past the Volvo. Like, why did they even put the old Volvos in the game? I want, like, the S60 T6. Hey, look! It's an Elise. And it's black. Like, there's like a little bit of disappointment. I'm a little bit disappointed. Because I was expecting it to be like a dark green. Oh my goodness, I am hauling ass. How the hell did these two get so far ahead? Here we go. Should I do like an entire episode without having the everything up? And just me in cockpit view? So we got a Lotus Esprit 350. Well, the Sport. So the same. And then the M3 GTR, okay. You don't have the badges to tame me. I have the badges to tame this. You don't have the speed to overtake. Hey, oh my god, this is really good. I'm the more and more I drive it, the more and more impressed I get with it. All it needs is some decent sounding racing exhaust, and this would be probably one of the best cars in the game. Drive at least. Keep that in third. It's got a lot of torque, so that's why it's doing that. And this is why it accelerates so quickly. My goodness. I am not disappointed with this car. At all. Except when it spun out. That was actually to be expected. We haven't hit anyone yet. We haven't hit anything yet. That's why it looks pristine. Going by the trees. We all break ourselves. Just a skosh. Wait, this is actually about the same color as the RX-7, which I think is really funny. Like, in the last episode, you know that RX-7 I was driving? Yes, the Rio Mia one. This is about the same color. Keep that in check. I'm surprised we actually nailed an apex on that one. Oh, excuse me. That monster is starting to fight back. No, I'm not going to throw up. It's just the gases. You know, anyways, as of doing the video for the vlog, I still have yet to do research on Martin Luther King Day or Martin Luther King Jr. Well, because I know he was a rights activist in the 1960s. And he ended up getting assassinated in 1968, so... Same year as, what, Robert Kennedy? Yeah, Robert Kennedy. The Kennedy family in politics was not very lucky. Assassinations, cancer, that kind of stuff. Well, I'm gonna find, like, a fun fact or something about Martin Luther King for my vlog, and then just probably ramble on something about that. So yeah, for me, I have no school tomorrow as I'm making the video. So I'm probably gonna post, I am going to post it on the Sunday prior to Martin Luther King Day. And I do apologize if I'm spamming you guys with videos, because I posted like 4 videos within the span of like 15 hours. That's because I actually wanted to get it done and over with. And I needed more room on my phone, so that's why I posted so quickly. As you may know, it's actually really easy to make videos because it's just me, it's just me doing commentary, It's just about, my races and whatnot. And it's completely unscripted, so that's why I just go on about things like what I'm doing right now, explaining as to what I even do. So anyway, Martin Luther King Day, gonna do a vlog. So that's probably gonna pan out pretty well. Ooh. If you heard that, yeah, I just popped my neck, so. People are gonna be thinking, ew, why? Because, my neck gets really sore if I don't pop it. So yeah. It's like relief. It's like pain relief. And we're finished with race 2, and we only have one more after this, which is good. I snapped and put a thumbs up. And we kicked ass. Oh, phone, you're drunk again. Why am I always... I always notice once per episode that phone is drunk. Is the phone sentient? Who knows? Nah, who am I kidding? It's something. Oh, and the second... Oh, this one is also 3 laps. This is not as big, but we're... Yeah, so 46,000. I'm not gonna do math. This is your record. This race has not been yet completed. Well, of course, because I'm gonna do it right now, and I'm going to win. I'm going to get to that gold. I'm going to get to that ass.
Hold up, I'm gonna do something real quick.
There we go. That unsprung. Wait. And nothing, son of a bitch. Nothing seems too interesting except for that Lotus Evora. It's in red. I do like the Lotus Evora, although it behaved weirdly when I was driving it in my old system. So let's see, opinions about each of the vehicles I overtake or have driven in previous Gran Turismo games. And damn, that took a while to load, actually. It's an evening race? Sort of morning race. I don't know, until it starts. Oh, we start further back. Okay, good. So I don't know what was in 12th. Let's see, 11th, the Brera. Had one in Gran Turismo 5, actually made a little competition with certain vehicles. The TT, I like the TT. I don't know why I don't have one yet. Clio V6, depends. Golf R, I don't know much about the Golfar, you know, from this game, because it's weird. I actually used that in the competition against the Brera, which actually turned out really well. The TTS. I had one in similar tune to this, except it was four-wheel drive. On the old system, so basically this is like the TTS, only it's rear-wheel drive. See, the Audi S4, the V8 version. I actually prefer the V6 version. Because I remember in Gran Turismo 5, I did a shuffle race with that car, and yeah, I did well, but I didn't like it very much. The Evora. The Evora is like the king of Lotuses, in my opinion, because I just completely wrecked house with it in GT5. GT6, not so much, as the handling and the physics model have changed. The Elise Sport 190. If it was a premium car, I would like it more. That's just my saying. If it was premium, I'd like it a lot more. Then the bastard M3. The bastard M3. That's all I gotta say about it. As it is sentient in my books. I do not have the badges to train it. And for this M4, well, you guys kind of already know about it. What's not to love about a Yasmarina Blue M4? With a racing transmission. And aero. It goes like hell. And the normal one is not necessarily a slouch either. You know, it's actually not that much slower than a Corvette. Put that into perspective. The C7 Corvette, it's not much slower at all. But the problem is, this is limited to 155. Which in the game, there are no such thing as those limiters. It is limited to 155, and then the Corvette can go all the way to 190. So yeah. Put that in perspective. Although I've seen this hit speeds north of 175. It hit like 181 in one video? Yeah, it hit 180 plus miles an hour on the Autobahn. And oh my, that was actually really risky through there. And yes, I do blast through that chicane. And I forgot to mention, I decided to opt out of the rocket for this car. Because I didn't feel like spending money to tune a vehicle that I'm just going to use later. So I'll just do it then. As I probably outbrake myself a little bit. And you can see everyone over there. All the slow bees. And the 6th. Coming across the finish line, 213. This is... I could definitely tell this is going to be a lot shorter than the previous video. Just due to the fact that I'm driving a more consistent vehicle, and it's on more consistent tracks. So this will probably be closer to like 27, 28 minutes, my prediction. I probably won't know what I'm going to use for the next episode, which is episode 17, the Tour of America. America! Oh yeah, coming to save the motherfucking day, yeah, America. Sorry, I had to do that. You get 1 million internet points if you comment what movie it's from. And trust me, I will look at the comments. We're rally crossing. That's fine. Still, million internet points. You can use that to buy something nice. Like a free subscription to my channel. And I gotta say, this track is actually really fun. But it's just too open, I should say. You know what I mean? Like, there's no, like, really no walls. There's really no walls, and you can just go on the other side of the track if you want to go. Which was my biggest gripe about Streets of Willow. It isn't as noticeable in this, on this track, as it's a much bigger track. So, yeah. That's gonna pretty much conclude this episode! So, of course, 70,000, nice. So we're at 633,000 credits now. Up from, like, 440. Yeah, so we made a lot of money in that. 200,000? 200,000? 200,000, can't talk. Does 200,000 sound about right? Well, anyway, coffee break, who cares about that? Up next is the Tour of America, which I am probably going to use an SRT Viper on. Wait, let me check regulation, 600, okay. So yeah, I'm going to use that, and then Supercar Festivale. So I'm just taking a look at this more intently. So yeah. There you have it. That's episode 16 of the A-Test series. So, yeah, pretty much it. So, Shizato's out. Until next time, enjoy the drive, guys. I mean it.